Once again, good morning all of you. I continue the last class. Last class I discussed the quantitative techniques in economic analysis. Last class we stopped the concept, the function, that is function when the where there is a direct relationship between the income and the time the person work. If the person increase the working hours, automatically his income also increases. In that case, per hour is the dependent variable, sorry, independent variable, income is the dependent variable. Number of hours is depending on the number of hours decides the person's income. It can be expressed in the in mathematical term as y equals f x or y equals a plus b x or y equals f x m n. In the first place, y equals fx, y is the dependent variable, x is the independent variable. Y is depending on only the one independent variable in the first equation. In the second function, y is depending on more than one independent variable. There are several types of functions based on the variables used. Functions, there are 16 functions. In the economics, we using only the 5 major functions, namely, one is linear, second one is non-linear, third one is exponential, fourth one is power function, fifth one is logarithmics. Here we discussing only the linear function. Under the linear function, the graphs are straight line. That means we can easily find out the linear function based on the style of the graph. It is straight line. That means either it means whatever it may be the angle, it should be the straight. Linear functions we can explain demand function and supply functions. Fundamental law of demand we know everyone. That means when price increase, automatically demand for the goods and services decreases. When price increase, demand decreases. There is a inverse relationship between these two. In the traditional economic theories, we simply says that when the price increase, demand decreases. But we are not able to quantify whatever the amount of demand decreases or the increasing of prices. What prices causes for the decreasing the amount of demand? It can be explained by demand equation, demand functions, and also the supply functions. Supply functions can be mathematically explained. Supply functions is the direct relationship between the income and price and quantity. When price increase, quantity supplied by the producers also increases. Price and demand. For example, take one example for the demand function. Okay. linear demand function. For example, 10 watches are sold when price is rupees 80 and 20 watches are sold when price is 60. We can write demand equation for this. For finding out the demand equation, we have the one formula, that is y minus y1 equals y2 minus y1 x2 minus x1. X minus x1, that means in that case x is the 10, x1 is 10, x2 is 20, as like that y1 is 80, y2 is 60. Just we apply these numerical values to the equation, y minus y1 value is 80 equals y2 value is 60, y1 value is 80 divided by x2 value is 20, x1 value is 10, as like that x minus x1 minus x1 value is 10. y minus 80 equals 60 minus 80, that is minus 20, over 20 minus 10, 10. This is x minus 10. y minus 80 equals 10 divided by minus 20, that is minus 2, x minus 10. Then y minus 80 equals minus 2 into x minus 2x minus 2 into plus x minus 2x, as like this minus 2 into minus 10 plus 20. Y minus 80, this minus become the plus when shifting the right side values to the left side, automatically minus become the plus, plus become the minus, that is plus 2x, that is minus 20 equals 0. y plus 2x minus 80 minus 20 is minus 100 equals 0. We have to shift the y plus 2x minus 100 to the right side. Y equals plus 100, minus 100 become the plus 100, this plus 2x become the minus 2x. This is the demand equation. Based on the demand equation, we can illustrate the demand function in a graph. Put x value 0, y equals 100 minus 2x, y equals 100 minus 2, 0, y equals 100. When x value is 5, y equals 100 minus 2, 5, y equals 100 minus 10, y equals 90. As like that, when x value is 10, y equals 100
minus 2, 10, y equals 100, 20, y equals 80. When x value is 15, y equals 100 minus 2, 15, y equals 100, 30, y equals 70. That means you can write the table values like x value and y value. X value is 0 at the time y value is 100, x value is 5 and at the time y value is 90, x value is 10 at the time y value is 80, x value 15 at the time y value is 70. That means based on the table we can illustrate these values in graph. It should be in straight line, it should be in straight line. Okay, this is the value, this is the price, price quantity demanded. That means 90, 0, sorry, 0, 5, 10, 15, 20. When 0, that is 100, when 5, that is 90, when 80, that is 70. We can illustrate the line. It is y equals 100 minus 2x. That means linear demand curve is straight line. Linear demand curve is straight line. This is the, we can conclude that functions, quantitative techniques in economic analysis are mostly most of the time useful in day to day life and also the in the day to day business, and also the policy makers of the administrators, politicians and economists. In that case functions play the important role. We can express the theoretical terms in a quantified terms, quantified views, as like that by constructing the demand equations and also the supply equations. Thank you. Thank you very much.